Welcome to Spider Auto. Today we're making a headlight installation video on a 2007-13 Chevy Silverado. Let's get started. First step, we're gonna move to the passenger side wheel well. We're gonna remove one 10 millimeter bolt so that we can peel open this wheel liner. Next, you're gonna peel open your wheel liner. Then you're gonna see one 10 millimeter bolt here, securing the bottom bracket of the headlight. All you're gonna have to do is loosen it. Next, we're gonna remove 8 plastic push pins securing the radiator shroud. After that, go ahead and remove your radiator shroud. Next, remove 4 10 millimeter bolts across the top of the grille. Next, using your pliers, we're gonna unclip the grill. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 clips. So you're just gonna go behind the grill and you're just gonna pinch the clip and release the grill. So here's the 6 clips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So you just get your pliers and just pinch and release. So before I remove the headlight, I applied masking tape on the bumper just to prevent any scratches. So next, what we're gonna do is remove 2 10 millimeter bolts. We have one here and one on top. Next, let's go ahead and unseat the headlight. So we're gonna shift it forward. Press down. And release. So here's the main connector. There's a tab here, press down and unplug it. So go ahead and bring over your old headlight, turn it over to the back. We're gonna disconnect the headlight harness. So disconnect your turn signals, turning it counterclockwise. You're gonna unplug your low beam and unplug your high beam. Then you're gonna unclip your connector. Go ahead and bring over your new headlight, turn it over to the back. So we have our low beam, high beam, and we have these two loose wires here. This powers the light bar. So we have our positive and negative. I'm gonna bring over your wire harness. Go ahead and inspect the rubber gasket seals on the turn signals. Make sure they are intact to prevent any moisture. Go ahead and install it into your new assembly. Turn it clockwise to lock it in place. You're gonna plug in your high beam. Make sure negative matches up with negative. And you're gonna plug in your low beam. Make sure your negative wire matches up with your negative wire and positive with positive. Next, we're gonna have to tap these two wires to the headlight harness. You're gonna tap into the positive and negative parking light wires. So if you need further instructions on how to T-tap, go ahead and click on the link in the description. So the T-tap connectors that I'll be using today comes with a male and female. I'm gonna tap the female onto the headlight harness. So I'm tapping into the positive parking light wire on the headlight harness. We're gonna grab another female T-tap and this will tap into the negative parking light wire on the headlight harness. Next, on the ends of these two wires, you're gonna install the male T-tap connector on the end. Make sure it has contact. You're gonna crimp it onto the wire. Make sure it's secure. You're gonna do the same to the negative. Now you're gonna take the negative wire and plug it into the female T-tap connector. That powers the negative. And then the positive with the positive. That's what it looks like. And we are ready to install our headlight. Gonna bring over your new headlight. Plug it in. Make sure it's secure and locked. Tuck our wires in. And we're gonna carefully seat our headlight in place. Drop it in. Press down. Tucks in the under fender. Make sure your bottom bracket lines up with the bolt. After seating your headlight, go to reinstall your two 10 millimeter bolts on the top of the headlight. Next, we're gonna tighten down the 10 millimeter bolt, securing the bottom bracket of the headlight. After that, we're gonna push our wheel liner back in place and then reinstall our 10 millimeter bolt, securing the wheel liner. After installing your passenger side headlight, let's repeat the same process to the opposite side. After installing your headlights, let's go to install our grill. Have your clips lined up. Pop them into place. After installing your grill, go ahead and reinstall your four 10 millimeter bolts across the top of the grill. Next, reinstall your radiator shroud, and then reinstall your eight plastic push pins. Now that we're finished with our headlight installation, let's close the hood and test all our headlight functions.